But who's it from? Ned Ashton.
What?
Give me a hand here, boys, would you?
Is this your idea of some kind of joke?
I wish it were. What the hell's going on here?
The end of the world as we know it.
Here you go. A memento for the occasion. My marriage certificate.
Lois.
Oh, and for many happy returns. Try this one on for size. Not only am I Mrs. Ned Ashton, but Mr. Ned Ashton is none other than Mr. Eddie Maine. You tell them, Eddie.
What is this? What does it mean?
Oh, it means that Ned and Eddie's double life is over, just like Eddie promised me. It means you're not Mrs. Ned Ashton, and I'm not Mrs. Eddie Maine. And Edward Lawrence Ashton is the biggest liar on the face of the earth. Celebrate that one, Katherine.
Lois.
Have a great party, folks.
Lois, Lois.
Is it true?
Let go.
Is it true?
Yes. Lois! Lois! Wait.
Not a word. Not another word from your lying mouth. Not ever again.
Lois!
No.
Listen to me.
Go!
Listen to me. Listen to me. Listen to me.
Who loves me? I don't know who you are. I don't even think you know who you are.
I'm Ned Ashton, who fell in love with a woman who changed my life, who made me love her and need her in a way that I have never loved or needed anyone.
You lied to me from day one. You let me give my heart to a lie and center everything I am around it. And while I was busy doing that, you were having an affair with somebody else. And then for some reason that I will never be able to understand, you married me, and then you married her. So this is your idea of love?
Blackmailed.
What?
Katherine blackmailed my family. And marriage to me was part of the deal. But I'm not married to her because I married you first.
What kind of a family lets a person get blackmailed into marriage?
The kind of family I was trying to protect you from.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah.
I thought you were trying to protect them. From somebody with a Brooklyn accent, half a college education, who manages a rock band.
No, that is the farthest thing from the truth. You gotta believe me.
Then why didn't you tell me who you were? And why didn't you tell them about me?
Because by the time I knew that I loved you, I knew that the person you loved was Eddie Maine. And I didn't want to lose you. And I didn't know how to get out of it.
Well, you're out of it now, pal.
No.
Let go of me, Eddie, whoever you are.
I was just trying to hold on to Katherine until I could get enough evidence against her, okay? To neutralize this threat to the family. But I have it now. Matt gave it to me last week. I'm planning to tell her tomorrow. And then I was going to come straight to you with the whole story. You can ask Brenda. Okay, she knows all of this. She knows what I've been through.
You know what? Brenda's a different matter. And I'll deal with Brenda. Both of you are liars, but your lies are worse, and I am never going to forgive you.
Dearly for this humiliation, and Ned is going to regret the day that he was born.
Use your head, Katherine. You can't hold Ned responsible for this debacle tonight.
Bigamy, Edward. Ned is responsible for bigamy. I am going to take him for everything he's got.
How angry is she?
Too angry to listen.
Get out of my way, Brenda.
Pleasure. You are immortal when you can imagine. I am going to sue you for bigamy. Then I am going to have the shirt off your back, the shoes off your feet, not to mention every share of ELQ stock and every dollar the court will allow me.
Allow me to explain why that's not going to happen.
Ah, now, really, would you have missed this for anything in the world?
Lucy, I am entertained beyond my wildest expectations.
And the night barely begun.
Oh, Grandfather, what do you think about our boy Ned now? Ned is actually Eddie Maine. Can you believe it?
What I'd like to believe is that Ned can control Katherine better than he can Lois. Because otherwise, Katherine is going to shove this Ray Conway business right down our throats.
I believe you suggested the endowment of a Quartermain wing at the state pen.
Digging me is a personal crime, Sean. I mean, we are a guest here. I think the least we could do is wait until somebody makes a personal complaint before you try to make an arrest on somebody, don't you think?
Oh, I figure I don't have too long to wait.
Performing as a rock singer for almost a year?
During which time I fell in love with and legally married Lois Cirillo.
1 week before you dared to marry me.
Revisionist history. 1 week before you dared to blackmail the Quartermain.
You committed bigamy.
Yeah.
Sonny is furious at both of us. I'm gonna go try and find Lois.
Try the gatehouse.
Pray for me. Brenda was in on it, wasn't she?
I couldn't have done it without Brenda. She's about the best friend I got right now.
And she's an accessory.
Forget it. All right, you're in no position to threaten me or Brenda or Alan or anyone else.
You give me one good reason why not.
Embezzle. In the amount of $110,000 in New York 2 years ago of your former lover, Mr. Joe Healy. You didn't leave him laughing, Katherine. In fact, if I tossed Max Scorpio's file on Katherine Bill onto Joe Healy's desk, he would bring charges in a millisecond. Especially when he found out that you pirated his software and handed it over to Damien Smith. And your PR firm, which covered for you, at Damien's request, would also give you up without a second thought. So now, who's looking at the jail sentence?
What if you miscalculated?
I'm not too bad with numbers. I think you can count on 10 to 15 years for embezzlement alone.
Now, what if I am so angry with you for this unspeakable double cross that I decide it's worth 15 years of my life to collect a fortune and the satisfaction of seeing you in jail, too?
You'd be less than human, and certainly less than Katherine, if you didn't entertain a few vengeful fantasies. Like my head on a pike, and the rest of me drawn and quartered.
That's a start.
But once you've had some time to collect your thoughts, I'd be willing to bet that the prospect of 15 years in shapeless cottons and brown lace-ups may not be worth it.
Don't bet on it.
It's your choice. Oh, by the way, I probably could arrange to have your good old buddy, Damien, there to keep you company. That would delight the hearts of the ELQ board.
You are taking a major chance.
Compared to what I may have lost tonight, it feels like nothing.
You cannot love that woman.
More than you or she will ever know.
Lois, I got nothing to say to you, Brenda. I'm so sorry.
For what?
For everything, for not knowing what to do.
Oh, yeah? Like the obvious never occurred to you,
There was no obvious, sure. Lois, please, you don't understand.
You got that right.
Ned is my friend, too. I love you both.
You were supposed to love me more. You were my best friend. You were my girlfriend. You were my woman friend. You were my partner. How could you have lied to me?
Ned was in love with you. And he was in love with himself as Eddie Maine. And he was so afraid that he was going to lose both of you if you found out the truth.
He was using me, Brenda. And you helped him do it.
No, he wasn't, I swear. Lois, he was having so much fun with you and he was changing. I mean, he was really becoming Eddie Maine. But he still had to be Ned Ashton. It was Ned Ashton who told you the lie about being a salesman because he was undercover in Buffalo and he was checking out some competitive hotel.
He was what?
Didn't he tell you any of this?
No. I didn't give him a chance. And I don't intend to.
Lois, the night that he took me to meet you in that club, I really knew that he was in love with you, and I could see how you felt about him, and I begged him to tell you the truth.
Oh, yeah, like either of you would have known the truth if it bit you on the leg.
Don't you understand that he was scared? He told me that a woman like you could never love Ned Ashton. And he said that Lois Cirillo would never understand why he had to lie to her in the first place. Don't you see? He told me that he had to keep this whole thing going because he'd never been
so happy in his whole life, and that is the truth.
So that was before I knew you. That was when I was just some chicky Ashton kept on the side, okay? But what about later, Brenda? What about partners?
I know, remember he tried to keep you from starting the record company?
Yeah, but you didn't.
Because I was hoping that it would force him to have to tell you. Because I couldn't hurt you.
As opposed to me watching Mr. and Mrs. Catherine Bell Ashton on the late night news.
Oh, God, I can't believe you saw that.
What did he think, huh? What did you think, that he could go on like this forever?
No! He was gonna tell you. He said he was gonna tell you. Mac only just got the information he needed on Katherine. He was gonna let her have her stupid party, and then he was gonna tell you tomorrow, Lois. He was.
Yeah, well, I heard that whole blackmail story, and I don't believe it either.
Ask the Quartermains. It's true. Ask Lila. Ask Jason.
They all knew.
Not about you. No, none of them knew about you until tonight.
No, did Corinthos know?
Sonny found out along with everyone else when he jumped out of that cake. And Sonny's furious with me.
Good. You deserve it.
Oh, Lois, please.
What did you think was gonna happen when Ned... Eddie, when Nedley finally came clean, huh?
I don't know. I guess I just thought that you guys loved each other so much that you would figure out a way to work it out.
Wrong.
Lois, please, don't. Lois, please. What about Alan B? What about Miguel and his band, Lois? What about all of our friends?
How did you ask me that? You think I'm bluffing?
I think you need some time to weigh your options. I'd suggest you take a room at the hotel tonight and give it some careful thought.
You'll hear from me tomorrow.
I have every confidence in your ability to do what's best for Katherine. And a prison term ain't it.
What an extraordinary evening.
What the hell are you doing out here by yourself? Where's Katherine?
I sent her over to the hotel for the night.
All right, Ned. Let's have it. Eddie Maine and the Idle Rich married to Lois?
Grandfather, not here. Take it back to the ranch.
Now, I demand a full explanation.
Don't be bombastic. Now, one thing I really need to know.
Yes, Grandmother, I love Lois.
Well, of course you do. How else could you sustain this muddle? The question is, was it really your picture in those leather pants?
Is that why you're so upset, Brenda? Because of the company? Because you're afraid you won't be able to play record company anymore?
Don't do that!
Tell the truth, heaven forbid!
L&B is important to me because it's us. You are the first true friend I've ever had, Lois. You know that.
Yeah? Well, then how do you treat your enemies?
Well, I certainly don't sit up all night and worry sick about them.
You want to know about sleepless nights, Brenda? Let me tell you. When you know the one man who you trusted and believed in, the man you loved like wildfire, who you gave your heart and your dreams to, who promised to love you as his wife, until death do you part. And you know that that man is a quarter of a mile up the drive in bed with another woman who somehow happens to be his other wife. And then you know that your soi-disant best friend knows this and hasn't bothered to even tell you the truth. That is bad. It's a sleepless night.
Lois, I don't know what to say to you.
How about so long, Lois, it's been real?
No, where are you going?
Insanity!